is producer director Vipul Shah, and as you can see, he is on the move. He's in his car. Are you on your way for a shoot? I'm guessing you're busy with work.
I am going to the shoot, though I had scheduled it differently, but now I have scheduled rescheduled it, so I'm going to the shoot.
So you have two projects coming up. You have Sanak that you're producing, and you have a web series, Human, as well. So which shoot is this?
So right now I'm going to the set of Humans, and then in the night I'll be after I pack up Human, I'm going to be going to Sanak set. Sanak is shooting nights these days, so I'll be going there in the night.
You have worked in with all sorts of mediums. You've worked in theater, you've worked in regional television, mainstream television, Hindi films, ad films, and now, of course, the OTT space as well. Currently, what is exciting you more? Do films excite you more, or is the web series exciting you more?
Actually, it's the story that excites the most. Once your story is great, then the medium you can choose. For example, Human was originally going to be a film. And when we wrote it approximately 3 years back, we kept writing draft after draft. But in some drafts, we could not focus more on the human drug testing angle because the personal relationships were dominating. And in some drafts, the personal relationships were suffering. And then I met Moses Singh and I gave it to him for a fresh look. And he developed this into a web series. And because I thought that the film was probably not going to give me enough time to tell the story. So we had decided to go into a web world, OTT, long format, as we call it. And so then Moses and his team wrote it. And now here we are shooting for it. So it's actually the story. But exciting thing is that every medium has a different way of showing a story also in terms of the treatment, the style of treatment, even the writing itself. And that is what is more exciting. So it's like departure from everything that I have done in films. In films, we have different hero characters. In OTT, even a gray is or a black character also can be the hero of the show. Like, for example, a Narcos is Pablo Escobar's story. And it's equally engaging. Or for that matter, Joker was for the first time made from a point of view of Batman. But they tried to make him sympathetic. Where OTT, you don't need to do that. You can just go ahead and show Pablo Escobar the way he is. And that freedom is fantastic in long format. So I'm enjoying it. Doing it very differently. So a lot of new learning for me also as a director.
All right,
So
and do tell me about Sanak as well. A lot of excitement with teaming up with Vidyut Jambal once again. Tell me about your association with him.
Vidyut and me, we've done four films before this. It's four we did together where we introduced him as the negative guy, and then we got Commando franchise and now Sanak. So it's a very emotional action space where there is a lot of emotion, and of course Vidyut is known for action, so there is going to be some action. But this is again, we are trying to be very, very different than Commando action. Action has lots of spaces, so we are going to try and show a completely new style of action in this film. Because he's not playing a commando, he's playing a common man and fighting for his love. So he's not going to be as skilled as commando is. But when you are fighting for your loved ones, the skill doesn't matter because at the end of the day, it's your spirit to save your loved ones and what length you can go to save them. That's most important. And I think that is what will make the action far more engaging, I believe.
Well, I think you are also very passionate about action films. A lot of your films have delved into all kind different kinds of action. But do you think in 2021 there's still a market for them?
I think if you look at world over, action films have survived the onslaught of OTT platforms to all the other formats. So even if you look at Hollywood, all the big superheroes are the top grosses of the year. If you look at even India, films like Uri or Tanaji or Holiday or all those films receive tremendous response. Commando franchise has been well received, very, very successful. We have a long debate about, you know, how audiences react to newcomers who are not from the film families. So we, here is one guy, Vidyut, whom we introduced, and today he's the hero of a very popular franchise, and people want to see more of Commando. So I think action has a very long time. And in India, particularly, the male audience in the cities and small towns, they love to see an action-adventure film. Of course, you have to find a new and emotional story every time because you cannot make similar stories. So that's the challenge with action. As far as Vidyut is concerned, I think there is sky is the limit.
Wow, all right. Excellent. You know, you are one of the most well-known producers in the business. You're a prolific filmmaker as well. According to you, how definitive has the year 2020 been for the Indian entertainment industry?
See, the whole world went through a transformation, right? And everybody sitting at home has got to a lot of international and world content. And I think because of that, now the cinema going experience will also be different. People will expect storytelling to be different. People are not going to accept certain things because the, I think this 2020 has been a very educational year as far as even audience. So the way audience wants to see cinema has changed quite dramatically. And I think that will be reflecting now in the way they respond to films. And so filmmakers have to really speed up and catch up with the change that audience has already experienced in their minds. It will be now visible when they see the film and they review it. We are all seeing that to the some of the reactions that we are seeing to the films that are releasing directly to the on our OTT platforms, the expectation from the audience changed. The films. So I think that is the biggest learning, and it's a good learning because education always makes you better. So now audience expectation is going to be better, so we have to deliver much better films.
Yeah, that's a challenge that filmmakers will definitely have to step up to.
Yes.
Now with theatre occupancy coming back to 100%, how soon do you think it will be before the business will come back to 100% as well?
I think audience is not shying, going to shy away from the films. Audience has shown a lot of occupancies. For say film like Master in Tamil and Crack in Telugu, they've done exceedingly well. And I'm sure when the big films in Hindi will release, like Suryavanshi or so many others, Radhe or even 83 or Jayanti Lal Jordan, all these big films, they are going to be received with tremendous response. I think the fear of corona is behind us. In our minds, we are not worried about the corona the way we were in last April or May or June.
Very true.
We moved on. The vaccine is here, which is a big mental, how would you call it?
Relief. Yeah.
Reassurance.
Yeah.
That, okay, we are safe and we can move on. The corona has been controlled very well by all the state governments and local governments. So the numbers have really come down. It's not as threatening as it was. And I think people are dying to come back to cinema and experience the cinema. So I think as and when the big films will come out, you will see a lot of audiences coming in.
All right. And I hope business is back to usual and back to normal very soon. Thank you so much for joining me today, and best of luck with all your upcoming projects.
Thank you so much. Thank you.